During spring migration, Deveaux Bank, less than half a square mile of shifting sand at the mouth of the North Edisto River, plays host to 20,000 Whimbrel. The newly discovered gathering represents half of this rapidly declining species' entire Atlantic Flyway population, all relying on Deveaux for nocturnal refuge. Biologists are now seizing the opportunity to deploy GPS transmitters on the Whimbrel, which record hundreds of precise locations every day. The data reveal an unprecedented Whimbrel's eye view of South Carolina's dynamic coastal ecosystem, evidence of the critical importance and rarity of safe havens like Deveaux Bank. To fuel annual migrations from South America to the Arctic, Whimbrel rely on the coastal habitats of the mid-Atlantic and southeastern United States. While coastal development and sea level rise encroach on narrowing margins for Whimbrel, South Carolina's Ace Basin still provides vast swaths of salt marsh, mudflats, and sandy shoals, all connected by tidal waterways. During low tides, when mudflats are exposed, tracking data reveal Whimbrel fanning out across the landscape. The species relies on vast habitats, while each individual commutes to a foraging territory of its own. Whimbrel seek out patches of soft, exposed mud, where essential fuel abounds. Throughout the spring stopover, Whimbrel forage heavily on fiddler crabs. Their bills are perfectly curved to probe the crab's muddy burrows. Rich in lipids and calcium, the fiddler crabs will be carried as fat and muscle on the Whimbrel's next flight to the Arctic. The eggs they'll lay on Canadian tundra some 3,000 miles away will literally be made of these South Carolina crabs. With the incoming tide, water levels can rise more than a foot every hour, and wide expanses of low-lying mudflat disappear rapidly. While the creeks and marshes flood and crabs retreat underwater, Whimbrel seek high ground nearby. Under the hot sun of midday high tides, any bit of elevation will do. Shellrakes, mounds of old oysters that naturally accumulate along the edges of rivers, provide respite. Whimbrel gather here in small groups until the tide ebbs and the foraging grounds reopen. But at night, when predators abound and visibility is low, these small shellrakes near dry land aren't safe. At dusk, Whimbrel take off from across the intertidal ecosystem. They converge at river mouths and move along the coast, headed for Deveaux Bank, the only refuge for miles. The island is uninhabited and entirely surrounded by water even at low tide. It's too isolated for predators to take hold, yet it's large enough to afford refuge for flocks of shorebirds to roost safely in open spaces. Deveaux Bank is unique. Its particular features and size are found nowhere else for hundreds of miles, and Whimbrel know it. They expend precious energy to arrive here from distant foraging grounds to rest and recuperate each night in the midst of transcontinental journeys. Human development and disturbance, increasing storm surge, and rising seas have made offshore refuges for shorebirds exceedingly rare. Without Deveaux Bank, 20,000 Whimbrel would have nowhere else to go. The habitats across South Carolina's Ace Basin are critical for sustaining a flyway that connects hemispheres. But data from individual Whimbrel show that Deveaux Bank is not only an island refuge, but a pivotal hub crucial to the function of this entire landscape. Across the Atlantic and Gulf coasts, the offshore roost sites that remain are vital pillars of the Atlantic Flyway. In order to sustain this rich natural heritage of hemispheric migrations, we must preserve the network of ephemeral shoals and undeveloped barrier islands that still exist alongside our own coastal communities.